Hi guys, so this will be a quick update video on the baby Gila monster. If you remember from last week's video, he had difficulty accepting food from my hand, but he ate when I left the food with him. Now you can see that he is comfortable enough to feed on my lap. So what happened was that I actually gave him the food, holding him, and then afterwards just put him on my knee here, and he's eating perfectly fine. Again, for those of you who are new to the channel, this is a banded Gila monster baby that I recently acquired. I'm trying to condition him to be calm around me. Gila monsters are venomous animals. Their venom is quite strong. So I wouldn't advise anybody to try this. This is completely the risk that I'm taking personally, plus my years of experience around these animals, around front-fanged venomous snakes, around Gila monsters, other heloderms. So, you know, I feel comfortable enough to do that, but it still has a risk. So I wouldn't advise anybody to try this for themselves. Gila monsters do not have fangs like snakes have. They have grooved teeth, and the way that they administer venom is that they bulldog you. So if they manage to get a hold of you, it's really hard to make them let go. One technique that I figured out over the years is that if you spray some vinegar into their mouth, diluted vinegar, they will let go in time. But again, by then you're already bleeding and venom is in your blood, and it's actually strong venom. So one has to be very careful around these guys. And, you know, my advice to you would be is to look at them from a distance, especially when they're feeding. However, I can tell you that this guy already calmed down significantly. And we have gone a long way in the last few days that we've been together. Gila monsters are intelligent lizards. In time, he will get to know my scent. And I think we will end up at a very good place where I will be able to easily manipulate this animal if needed. As you can see, he is really tongue flicking because, as I said, their feeding behavior is usually eating multiple prey items and not feeding for a long time. But this is what he will get from me for today. And I will not try to hold him at this stage because my fingers have mouse scent and their eyesight is not very great. I don't want to risk getting bitten by him. I'll just gently put him back to his cage. Thanks for watching, guys. Have a good weekend.